Hey everyone, first and foremost, Merry Christmas to everyone out there. I hope you were able to spend Christmas with those who you deem worthy. And I hope the new year, the coming new year, brings you good fortune, prosperity, and wisdom. With that being said, on with the video. Ron Paul. Oh my gosh. Finally, the media has given this guy a platform to be heard. Ron Paul, you know, he's a breath of fresh air. To those of you who don't know who Ron Paul is, first and foremost, this guy is a Republican congressman from Texas. He's running for president. He's running for the Republican nomination for president. And his message is quite simple. So simple that people are still dismissing it. Less taxes, small government, bringing our troops home, not interfering in other countries' businesses, and most importantly of all, concentrating on America. I mean, that's the most, one more thing, and the Constitution. This guy follows the Constitution, not in just the spirit of, but in the letter of the law. The Constitution, I should say. That I find very, very, very attracting. It's attracting because how many of the candidates out there, especially the current president, have followed the Constitution to the letter? Not very many. I like Ron Paul's message. I like the way he speaks. He's very eloquent, and he speaks very intelligently. I've yet to find an issue that Ron Paul has misspoke and basically backtracked like the other politicians. As a matter of fact, I don't consider Ron Paul a politician. I consider Ron Paul a statesman. There's a difference, trust me. But nonetheless, his message is quite clear, concise, eloquent, and it's the very same message that George Washington advocated when he was president, or I should say when he made his farewell address when he was leaving the White House. And it was basically the exact same thing. Stay out of entangling alliances, trade with countries, talk with countries, engage them diplomatically, never have a permanent alliance, all these things that we did, the United States government did consistently for like the first 100 years of the country. And guess what? America was prosperous. Yes, there were things that happened along the way, but we were able to stay consistent in what we established here. That is a Republican democracy. But nonetheless, the media have dismissed this guy since 2008 as being some libertarian-leaning Republican who doesn't know what he's talking about. But when you look at what he had to say during the debates, the last debates in 2008, he took the debates by storm. But yet the media made the huge mistake and ignored him. And now look where we're at. We're still in Iraq, we're still in Afghanistan, we're still in Saudi Arabia, we're still in Kuwait. I mean, how much money, how many lives are we willing to sacrifice just to keep this policy of driving this country broke? I mean, and that's the message that Ron Paul has been saying. You know, when are we willing to take a step back and look at what we're doing and go, wow, you know, we shouldn't be doing this no more? I would encourage everyone out there, look at what Ron Paul has to say. Whether you agree with him or not, whether you agreed with Republicans or not, this guy is a different Republican. I will vouch for that. He is a different Republican. I'm going to link his websites and the things that Ron Paul has had to say over the years. And like I said, you will not be let down by Ron Paul. With that being said, in the coming new year, I hope you're prosperous, and I hope the new year brings you good fortune. With that being said, peace out, folks.